going to use the standard normal table to find the area between negative 1.08 and 2.01. Now that's also the same thing as finding the probability of getting a z-score between negative 1.08 and 2.01. So sketching what is being asked, I'm going to attempt to draw a standard normal curve, and that is horrible, my apologies. And I'm starting at negative 1.08, and I'm stopping at positive 2.01. So I don't have two symmetric areas about zero. All right, so I'm shading an in-between case here. So to use the standard normal table, I have to use this twice. Okay, so I need to first find the probability z is less than 2.01, and then I need to subtract out the probability z is less than negative 1.08. So in other words, I'm finding this larger area from negative infinity up to 2.01, and I'm subtracting out the piece I don't want. So this is this right here. I'm subtracting out this unshaded tail. So going to my standard normal table, I first want to go to the page that reads for a positive z-score. And I want to go down to 2.0 and over to 0.01, where that row and that column intersect is 0.9778. So that's that first piece, 0.9778. And I want to subtract out the smaller tail here, the area that corresponds to the left of negative 1.08. So I need to go to the page that corresponds to negative z-scores. And I want to go down to negative 1.0. Oops, negative 1.0 and over to 0.08. Okay, I know this table is a little tricky to read. I need a large font table. All right, so intersecting that row and that column, I get 0.1401. Okay, so this right here would represent this area in this unshaded tail. And doing that subtraction in my calculator real quick, 401, I get an area of 0.8377. And that's also the probability of getting a z-score between those two values. So about 83.77% of the area has been shaded.